back in the day, which now happens to be about, whoa, 7, 8, 9, 10 years ago, I worked at a convenience store for a summer when I was getting my master's degree. And in those days, friends of mine and I used to post on blogs on Yahoo 360. And Becky and Paul, you know who you are, and there are some others as well. And I wrote a post on this blog one day about the value of kindness. And I'm sure that I wrote about it a couple of years after I worked at the convenience store and after the experience occurred. And this blog about kindness had to do with a mentally handicapped man who used to come into the store. He would develop attractions and affection for the women who work there, and I had been warned about him. And he came into the store one day, and he had something in his hand that he was showing me, and it was snail shells. And I can't remember if they were fossilized or not, but they were empty of their inhabitants. And I asked him, where did you get these? And he said, I found them in the dry creek out behind my trailer. And the trailer house was quite something to be seen, but I won't go into that. And I said, oh. And he said, yes, I was out there digging for change. And he had some pennies in his hand that were quite green and quite encrusted with dirt and corrosion. I had no idea why he had the state of mind to go out and dig for this change, but at any rate, he had the shells and he had the change and he gave the shells to me. And I was very touched by his gift, but at the same time, I was really loath to accept them because I remembered the warnings about his easy affection and then his I won't say inability, but his unwillingness to leave the women alone for whom he had developed the attraction. And I said, oh, I can't take your shells. You dug them up. You found them. And he insisted. And so I did. And I really hate to say, I don't know what I did with them. I've moved 4 or 5 times since then, and they got lost in the shuffle. And it was a very, very hot day outside. 100 degrees or more. And he would walk, obviously, because he couldn't get a driver's license. And I think his mother drove, but she had not driven him to the store that day. She was marginally smarter than he was. But he had walked to the store that day, and it was probably not maybe a mile. And he bought some cigarettes, as I recall, because he was of age, and maybe a soda. And he paid for it with a handful of change, including the encrusted pennies. And he had some change left over. And he asked me, how much does a bag of ice cost? And I said, $1.50, whatever the price was. And he said, do I have enough money to buy a bag of ice? And I said, no, you don't. I'm sorry. And he said, oh, well, that's really too bad, because I wanted to put it inside my shirt when I walked home because it's so hot outside. Now, this presented me with an ethical dilemma. 99 cents, $1.49, $2. What would it really have cost me to say, all right, give me your money and go get a bag of ice? But I didn't do that. And it wasn't because of the money. It went back to that attraction, affection, problem. I really did not want to encourage this young man to become attached to me for several reasons. One is he was going to get his heart broken if it was capable of being broken, which I suppose it was. And number two, I really didn't want to put up with the give and take of being courted by him. But that didn't make me feel any better about him walking home in triple-digit heat, because I was too selfish and unwilling to pay out of my pocket to make up the difference for a bag of ice. I didn't owe him anything. It's not a matter of owing anybody kindness, because kindness should come from inside, and it shouldn't be something that we feel we owe to people, but something that we do out of the kindness of our hearts. Now, back in present time, today is a matter of fact. And for want to preface the experience that I had today by saying I used to read quite often bumper stickers and posters that said, perform random acts of kindness and senseless acts of beauty. Well, today I had a random act of kindness performed upon me. And I do try to do that. I do try to practice random acts of kindness. But today I was in Walmart buying some groceries, and I had on a long brown skirt and a red long sleeve top and a brown crocheted sweater and brown boots. And an elderly woman came up to me. Really old woman. She had to have been in her 80s. Very thin. And she was dressed in a green button-up blouse. And she had a green scarf around her neck. And she came up to me and she said, I love what you have on. And I said, thank you very much. And then she proceeded to say, but it needs a little bit more red. And I said, do you think so? And I indicated that the zipper on my boot, which is a fake zipper, had red on it. And she said, that's one thing. But she said, it really would have looked nice with a red scarf. And I told her that I rarely wear scarves because I don't like things around my neck. I don't like sleeves. And I really can't stand anything up against my neck, as people who know me well know that, and I attribute it to being hanged as a witch too many times in past lives. And she put her hands to her own throat where she had her scarf knotted, and she said, oh, I need something around my throat because I get so cold. And I said, I certainly understand that. And I said, I used to weigh 250 pounds, and this doesn't come from my age, but from having lost weight. And she said, you certainly don't look like you ever weighed that much. And then she gestured my face and she said, you have a beautiful face. And I said, thank you. Now, I have had more than a couple of men tell me that I'm beautiful, and I always take it with a grain of salt. Men who love me, I accept it as a wonderful compliment because that's how they see me, as being beautiful. And I hope that it comes from more from just the face, but also the spirit that is within me. But coming from an 80-something-year-old woman, that means something. And it also reminds me of another experience I had in a McDonald's once, where a total stranger, a woman came up to me. I had been talking to an elderly gentleman whom I knew, and a woman came up to me and hugged me and said, you are beautiful inside and out. Now, I want to stress, I'm not telling about these experiences because I'm bragging or because I do think that I'm beautiful, though I am. And I'm not beautiful because of the way that I look, but because I feel beautiful because an 80-year-old woman today told me, you are beautiful. A random act of kindness, and I thanked her, and she said, there are too many negative people in the world, and we need to tell more people good things about themselves. Random acts of kindness. I need to make a practice more of random acts of kindness. And so do you. Humans are intrinsically unkind and cruel. But by the same token, we are inherently kind. And so often in our world, the kindness goes unspoken. In Ursula Le Guin's story, The Ones Who Walk Away from Amelis, she says, all smiles have become archaic, old-fashioned, out of style. And in some ways, I fear that she's right. But in many other ways, she's very wrong because Sharing a smile cost us nothing. I cannot go back in time and tell this young man, no, you don't have enough money to buy a bag of ice, but you know something? I'm going to make up the rest of the money. Go get that bag of ice and put it in your shirt and walk home. It's too late for me to do that, but it's not too late for me to tell another woman, you are beautiful. And it's not too late for me to extend kindnesses to other people, both the ones whom I love and the ones whom I do not even know. And so, I encourage you, random acts of kindness, practice it.